This Week in the Boardroom, brought to you by Corporate Board Member and host NYSE Euronext, along with Governance Knowledge Partners, the Center for Audit Quality, and Grant Thornton, and contributing partners, National Investor Relations Institute, and the Society of Corporate Secretaries and Governance Professionals.
Welcome to this edition of This Week in the Boardroom. I'm TK Kerstetter with Corporate Board Member, and we've got a great show today. We're going to talk about a little bit about leadership in challenging times. And joining me as a guest with somebody in experience with, in challenging times is Coley Bailey, who's a director with Terra Nitrogen Company. And he also served as CEO and chair of a related organization, and now is the chairman of the NomGov committee and the audit committee for that company. And Coley, welcome.
Good, welcome. Not the audit committee, but the compensation. I'm on the audit committee, yeah. But not chairman of audit.
Thank you for making sure I got that correct. I don't want other directors to be giving me a call with wrong information. So you had the experience of serving as chairman and then subsequently a short time as CEO for a company that had gone through restructuring, okay? And restructuring is always a challenge. We just came through a horrible financial crisis. A lot of companies have found themselves in that position. My question to you is really around this issue of leadership skills. When you have a situation when you're restructuring or coming out of bankruptcy or doing anything like that, how do you handle board leadership, and how do you motivate your company and your employees in situations like that?
Well, the first thing I believe you have to remember as a board member when the situation becomes challenging is that you have many stakeholders. You have the stockholders, you have the bondholders, you have the banks, you have employees, and in difficult situations you may have some state or federal involvement. And to manage these people and to keep them informed and not to tell them what to do is a very difficult task. Now, you mentioned that I did become, during this company's bankruptcy, become the CEO. I'd been the longtime chairman of the company, but never been actively involved in management. I became the CEO and was really amazed. I was sitting in the conference room next to my office, and I had PhD engineers, accountants, all the upper level management of the company sitting around the table, and we went through a presentation, and then it got real quiet and everybody turned and looked at me. I had to make the decision, and I was willing to do that. I realized that I did not know the answers. I had no baggage by having taken us down this road in a management situation. I did not know the answers and knew I didn't know the answers and said so. I said so to everybody involved. And my job was to make the pie bigger. That's what everybody wanted. That's what the bondholders wanted. That's what the stockholders wanted. We just didn't have enough pie. We wanted to, because of the situation we found ourselves in, there wasn't a big enough pie. I, with the advice of the CRO, in fact, in less than a year's time, more than doubled the enterprise value of the company, which pleased everyone. How did we do that? We brought everybody into the tent. I became close friends with the chairman of the creditors committee, which is unusual for a company in Chapter 11 and its CEO to become friends with the creditors committee. I wanted his input. I wanted the input for the people who had made investments in this company. I never will forget, in this same room, we had a conference one day, and our dip lender had made a mistake in a calculation. And he said he had presented his proposal, and the advisors were sort of giving high fives around the room that, okay, we got this guy just where we wanted. And it was next door, my conference room was next door to my office. So I said, just wait just a minute. And they said, what are you going to do? I said, I'm fixed to go call the dip lender and tell him he made a mistake. You could have heard a pin drop in that room. I did that, and it essentially changed the whole attitude of the stakeholders in that case. Okay, these guys are trying to do the right thing, trying to do what's fair, and they're letting everybody have input. Really made a big difference in that case. We also had a problem that many of the investors or stakeholders wanted an environmental issue, and they just wanted to dump that on the state of Mississippi. And the company was a huge company and had operations around the world, there was an environmental issue that affected the state of Mississippi, and the general consensus was we walk away from that environmental issue and the state of Mississippi will deal with that. It just so happens that the chairman of the creditors committee, father, had been a conservation officer in the state of Indiana. And he, along with me and several other people, believed that that was not the appropriate thing to do. So that, taking that stand environmentally, made a big difference in people trusting us to, in fact, do the right thing and not just milk the very last possible cash out of the company.
Well, sounds like the combination of doing the right thing and communicating with all parties ends up to be the critical issue. So that leads me to something that raises my curiosity. So you go through this experience. I know it's trying. Okay, you take that over. So what about that experience made you a better director today? I mean, what sort of did you learn from that experience that makes you a more valuable director today?
I think I'm more aware of red flags. I'm more aware of smells. And a close friend of mine told me once to react to smells. When things are not exactly right, don't just dismiss them as chance. Figure out why they're not right. I think that's very important. Listening to questions, listening to people's opinions. One of the biggest mistakes board members often make is they get their information from one source. Their information is filtered through the hierarchy, if you will, or the management of the company, instead of delivering directors facts and letting the directors make up their own mind. I think that is a very dangerous situation for a board member to find himself in. And I think gathering information through more than one filter is very, very important.
So now you take all this experience, and now you're a chair of the nominating governance committee. Okay, so now you're responsible for going out and recruiting directors to make a good board. So tell me about what you look for in attributes and characteristics and whatever that helps you formulate the kind of board you want to put together.
I think it's critical for a publicly owned company to have directors that are truly independent. Of course, it goes without saying, TK, that a director should be smart, but a director should also have the time and the willingness to invest that time in this company, to learn about the company, learn about its products, learn about the issues that are facing the company. I believe that not all of the directors, but I believe that some of the directors on most companies should have product in use experience. Let me see if I can put that in a little simpler terms. I think John Deere and Monsanto should have a farmer on their board. Now all their board members shouldn't be farmers, but they should be a farmer on John Deere's board, because after all, those are the guys that are buying the equipment they make. And Monsanto, those are the guys that are buying the technology Monsanto sells. And I believe that strongly. And I believe that's an issue that many companies have not addressed. They've gotten people that have achieved in other areas, but not necessarily been attuned to people that have that are buying the products that in fact they are selling. A matrix mind is important because there are a lot of different things that can affect the well-being of a corporation. An entrepreneurial spirit is maybe the best and single most important quality of a board member. And now I've served on some nonprofit boards with middle manager types on the board, and you get so bogged down in the details and in checking the boxes that you don't never get anything done. And an entrepreneurial guy who's used to making a decision with a limited amount of information, moving forward with that decision, reviewing it and changing it if it's not the right one, but one who is willing to make a decision and move forward and be able to defend that position given the best information available at the time he made that decision.
Well, it's an interesting criteria, and not one, none of that can one argue with and what would make a good director. So now I've got you in the studio here, and I want to ask you a question that I ask a lot of people. When you look at the environment with all the experience you have, and you look at the financial crisis we just came through, we just had an election, we just had Dodd-Frank, what sort of concerns you about inside the boardroom and the economy relative to what you see? And then on the other side of the spectrum, what sort of gives you hope or confidence about what lies ahead? So let's start with what concerns you first.
Well, I'm concerned as to how we get income, disposable income, into the hands of the middle class, because that alone is what's going to turn our economy around. That's a big question for economists and people a lot smarter than I am, but that does concern me. From a boardroom perspective, I think the issues facing us are not wealth transfers, but maybe a wealth contraction. We've seen this some in many segments of the real estate industry where the values have just disappeared. I think we've got to be cognizant that those values can in fact disappear, and we've got to take steps to ensure that that doesn't happen within our corporations. Low interest rates, while are both good and bad, they've allowed us the luxury of putting off some difficult decisions by sort of kicking the can down the road. And I'm bothered by kicking the can down the road, personally, from a corporate point of view, and from our government's point of view. I'm concerned about regulation and taxes. I mean, everybody wants clean air. Everybody wants cheap gasoline. Everybody wants to be able to conduct business in a very efficient manner. But those are the things that really concern me.
Yeah. Well, then let's end on a positive note. Tell me, as you look forward, what sort of gives you hope about, again, what you see ahead, and particularly what you see ahead in the boardroom?
I think technology will allow us to lower the cost of energy, lower the cost of food, lower the cost of transportation. And embracing that technology, it can make a huge, huge difference in our ability to be efficient. Not efficient like we used to think efficient, but efficient by being through technology. And I believe that is that's the really big bright spot from a corporate point of view. Other thing that it seems to be getting some traction is education. And if we're going to compete in this world, we've got to have an educated workforce that's willing to work, and the corporations need to step up and buy into the fact that education is a lifelong process that begins at a very early age and continues to throughout our entire lives.
Education is what this week in the boardroom is all about. So we're happy to have you, Coley, joining us today. Pass along a little wisdom to our group. And that will conclude this edition of This Week in the Boardroom. And we've hoped you enjoyed this week. And we'll be back again next week where we'll take a look at another topic that will help you be a better board member or a committee member. And we'll see you then.
Join us again next week for This Week in the Boardroom, brought to you by Corporate Board Member and host NYSE Euronext, along with Governance Knowledge Partners, the Center for Audit Quality, and Grant Thornton, and contributing partners, National Investor Relations Institute, and the Society of Corporate Secretaries and Governance Professionals.